So we will continue our geometry discussion. This is part 6 of the discussion. So we have already discussed all the concepts and many difficult questions. So now today let me start off with a very easy question. Okay, you don't even want 30 seconds to solve this question. So take 30 seconds and solve this question. Okay, so how will you solve this question? What is given? Diameter is AB. So this AB is the diameter and radius is given as 6.5. So diameter is given directly as 13, right? So diameter is given 13. Then chord CA is given as 5 centimeters. So this is 13, this is 5. So what you need? You need to find the area of the triangle, right? So if you get this, you can find the area. There are many equations, okay? This will be the easiest ever I'll discuss in my class, okay? So what is the area? It's very simple. So this side is going to be 12, okay? You will apply Pythagoras theorem. There is no point in discussing all those things, right? So you'll get this as 12. So then you can use half BH. So base is 5 and height is 12. Okay, this is right angle triangle. So you can use Pythagoras theorem to get this. Okay, otherwise also I have told you the method in which you can find the Pythagonal triplets faster in our discussion on chapter of squares. Okay, so you can apply that also. Or here it is very simple. You get this as 12. So obviously half BH you will get 30. Okay, so half into 5 into height is 12. So 60 by 2, that is 30. Very easy question. Now, I don't remember the year in which it is asked. Okay, so whatever it is, this was asked in some of the year. Now, again, we have discussed the concept related to this question in the previous discussion. So take a minute and solve this question. Very easy question. Okay, so what is given? A square is drawn by joining the midpoints of the sides of the given square. Okay, so it's like this. You have a square, okay, and you join the midpoints and you will get another square, okay, and the third square is drawn inside the second square in the same way, and this process is continued indefinitely. So again you joining the midpoints, okay, like this. So you get the third square, and this process continued indefinitely means you get the fourth square, you get the fifth square, so it continued indefinitely. Now, if side of the first square is given as 8, so one side is given as 8, okay, so obviously we will get the area of the outer square as 64, okay, so outer square area is 64. What you need to find is the sum of the areas of all such squares formed. So infinite number of squares is formed, you need to find the sum of all squares. So obviously the first one is 64, you need to get the second, third, fourth, fifth, and everything you need to add. That's the idea. Now how will you solve this question? Okay, see, what will be the area of the second square? See, if you remember in the previous discussion, so the second square was formed like this by joining the midpoints, right? Like this. Now, if you use the method that we have discussed, cut and count, you can see if you divide the diagram like this, you'll get 8 equal areas. Out of that, 4 corresponds to the small one and 8 corresponds to the big one. So the ratio is actually 4 by 8 or 1 by 2. So the ratio of area of the bigger square and the smaller square is actually 1 by 2. So if the outer area is given as 64, the second square, so this is 64 means this has to be 32. Or if you remember in one of the other discussion we have discussed, you have a square, right? And you have a circle. So if this is 4, this is pi, and another square. If there is another square, this has to be 2. So again, from this also you can understand 4, 2, that means 1 is to 2. Okay, so here ratio is like 64 and 32. So inside 32, if you make another square, what will be the area? That is going to be 16. Inside 16, if you make another square, what is going to be the area? That is going to be 8. So if you look here, first will be 64, then you have 32, then you have 16, then you have 8, the next will be obviously half of it, that will be 4, 2, 1, 1 by 2, it will go on like that because it goes indefinitely. Okay, now towards the end you will get a negligible value, but anyway we want to know the total area of all the squares. So if you look here, you can understand that you are going to get a GP. And we have discussed about AP and GP in one of our previous lectures. We have discussed in detail. So it's actually a decreasing GP where the common ratio is 1 by 2. The common ratio is 1 by 2. So the sum of terms of GP is what you need to find out. Okay. So these things you need to add, these areas you need to add. So sum of n terms in an infinite AP. See, if you know the first term A, the common ratio, if you know, A divided by 1 minus R. So here 1 minus 1 by 2. So A is actually 64. 1 minus 1 by 2 means 1 by 2. So it's actually 128. Now onwards, if you see this kind of question, you don't want to think this, you don't want to do all these things. The moment you see 8 is one side, so the area is 64, your answer will be twice of it. Okay, so you'll mark 128 as the answer. Next time, the same pattern will be repeating, and instead of 8, they will give you one side is 16. So if one side is 16, what is the area? 256 is the area of the outer square. So what will be the total area? It will be twice of it. That means 512. So the total area, if they're asking, 512. So now onwards, this pattern will be there. Everything else will be there. Instead of this 8, I can give you different. If let's suppose I'm giving you 10. One side is 10. So outer area is 100. So total area will be 200. It's nothing but twice of what is there. Why? Because what you're actually getting is a decreasing GP. If one side is 10, first area will be 100. Second will be 50, third will be 25, next will be 12.5, it will go. So it's a decreasing GP where the common ratio is 1 by 2. Your answer will be 100 by 1 minus 1 by 2. Now, this is always 1 by 2, this common ratio. That's why I told you take twice of it, because 1 minus 1 by 2 is always 1 by 2. Now, when that 1 by 2 goes to the numerator, it become multiplied by 2, right? So you will get it as 200. Now onwards, it's just a matter of knowing this one side, right? The pattern will remain the same. You can expect this question in CAT or even the SSE or bank, any kind of exam that you're going to take. This is a standard question. So joining the midpoints. So what is the total area? Now, let's suppose instead of indefinitely, if they are telling this is continued for 4 times, then also your answer is ready. You need to find the sum of first 4 terms, okay? Or if they are telling 10 times, you need to find the sum of first 10 terms. We have already discussed this and the method and formula, etc. Or sum of 10 terms or 20 terms or whatever it is. If it is indefinitely, you may think that it is difficult, but if it is indefinitely, that's the easiest one. You know the outer area, that is 64, total area will be twice of it, 128. As easy as you can get. Again, similar pattern that we have already discussed. You take a minute and solve this question. So how will you solve this question? See what is given. There is a square, a circle is inscribed, right? So square and a circle inscribed in the square. Okay, so a circle inscribed in a given square and another circle circumscribe about the square. So you have one more circle which circumscribe the square like this. Okay, then what is the question? What is the ratio of the area of the inscribed circle to that of the circumscribed circle? This is going to be a very easy question. So we already know if this is pi, this square has to be 2 and this has to be pi by 2. Okay, so now there is no need to consider the square here. You just need to know this is pi and this is pi by 2. So the area is actually half. So you can pick this as the answer, 1 is to 2. Very simple question. You just need to know this, if there is a square, okay, inside the square there is a circle, the ratio is 4 pi, okay. Now, there is a square, inside the square there is another square, the ratio is 2, 1, okay. Now, here, that means if this is 4, if I am putting another square here, that has to be 2, that has to be 2. Now, if that is 2, if I put another circle here, that has to be pi by 2 because 4 pi ratio has to be maintained. So you can see here, if you remove this outer square, if you remove this outer square, what is left out is what the question, right? You have a circle here, you have a circle here, then a square, then a square, then a circle, then a circle. So the ratio is actually pi and pi by 2. This is what you need to know. Then it is easy. Now, again, one of a tricky question, take a minute and solve this question. This was asked in 2006 and you had 5 options. Okay, so take a minute and solve this question. Okay, the most important point here is how you're going to visualize this, because the diagram is not given. So how will you visualize this? See, you know ABCD is the square, okay? And see, triangle is BPC. So the equilateral triangle is drawn inside a square, okay? So here also you have a BC, here also you have a BC. So one side of the triangle is actually one side of the square. Okay, what is that side? That is BC. So you need to visualize in such a way that BC is the common side for the square as well as the triangle. Okay, So, and let's try to draw that, then you may get some idea, okay? So let's draw the square first, okay? Now, let's keep this as A, B, C, D. Now, what we know is actually, BC is the side of the triangle also, right? Now, the point is, it's an equilateral triangle. That means all the three sides has to be equal. So, you need to draw an equilateral triangle, something like this, okay? The idea should be, this side and this, all the three should be equal. That means it won't go and touch on the top of the square, then the length will be more, right? So, somewhere like this, something like this. And this point, we know this is P, because BPZ is the triangle. So, BPZ is the triangle, right? So, for us, this point is P. I hope this much is clear. This is how you can visualize. Now, what is asked is, this angle, right? This angle, that is what APD. Why this is P? Because BPZ is the triangle and BC we know that's a part of square. So only point which is left out is this one to keep as P, right? Now what we need to find out is APD. Very interesting question. Now, how will you start with? See, this three angles has to be 60, 60, 60, right? So angle PBC, angle PBC, okay, comma, angle CPB, right, CPB, and angle BPC all has to be 60 because all the three sides are equal and it's an equilateral triangle, so 60. Okay, now how will I get the other angle? See, this side and this side is equal, so actually PC and DC are equal. Okay, why? Because DC is the side of the square and PC is also nothing but the same size, right? Because we are actually starting with the side of the square. So both are equal, so both angle has to be same. Now how will you find, so opposite of this, this angle, and opposite of this, this angle. So these two angle will be same. But how can you find it? So there is one way to find it because we know this is 60. So can you find this? DCB is a right angle, right? So here it is right angle. So when this is right angle, that is 90 degree. So we get this as 30. So once you know angle DCP, okay, angle DCP is equal to 30. Now PDC and DPC, okay, is going to be very easy. Angle PDC equal to angle DPC. Okay, the reason is both sides are equal, so opposite angles will be equal. Now, what will be that? Some of them will be actually, see, if you consider that triangle, triangle DPC, that is 180. Out of that, we know one angle is 30. So, balance this two together is 150. Okay, so both of them together, if you add, you get 150. So, both of them will be equal to, this is equal to 75. This will also be 75. So we get this angle and this angle as 75. In the same way, this side PB and AB are equal and we know this is 60. So we will get this as 30. And the same method, there is no point in writing it again. We get this as 75 and we get this as 75. So this is 75, this is 75, this is 75, this is 75. So angle PAB is equal to 75. Angle APB is also equal to 75. This is 75, this is 75. Now it's done, right? See, we need this angle APD. Angle APD is what you need to find out. You know this three angle together, okay? Because this is 75, and this is part of equilateral triangle, so that is 60. So if you have any confusion, let me write it. Angle APB is equal to 75. Angle DPC equal to 75, angle BPC is equal to 60 because that is part of the equilateral triangle. So all these together you get 210. So the total is 360. So APD will be, angle APD is equal to 360 minus 210. That means 150. Okay, 150. Very simple but very tricky question. The point is the way you are going to visualize it, right? See, here you need to see this common point, that is BC here and BC here. From that you understood one of the side of the triangle is lying on one of the side of the square, that is BC. Now, from that, now it is easy. This side, these two sides are equal. So, you get 60, 60, 60.
Now from that you get this as 30 and this as 30. Now we know this side and this side is equal. So the angle, opposite angle has to be same. So one angle we know 30, so both of them together will be 150, so that you can divide equally, so you get 75 75. Same thing you have done here also. So you got all these angles together as 210. What is left out as 150, and that's your answer. Very tricky question, but very simple. I hope this is clear for all of you. Now take a minute and solve this question. Now what we need to find out here is sum of perimeters of the triangles, right? See, the base of each triangle will be counted once. So the sum of the perimeters of the triangle will be actually perimeter of the square, okay, perimeter of the square plus what you can do is 2 times sum of its diagonals, right? So 2 times sum of diagonals, okay? So perimeter of the square plus 2 times sum of the diagonal, you will get the answer. Now if you want me to find the answer, but each of the other two sides of the triangle is common to 2 triangles, it will be counted twice. Then what we need to do? So what you can finally conclude is, now what is area of the square? Area of the square is equal to 4. Therefore, you know the length is 2, right? Area is given as 4. So you know the length is 2. So if the length is 2, the perimeter of the square is 8. And the side is 2, so the diagonal is 2 root 2, right? So the diagonal is 2 root 2. So what is the required perimeter? See, the perimeter of the square, that is 8 plus 2 times, okay, the sum of 2 diagonals. So 2 times 4 root 2. So you can take 8 out because these two will form 8. So 8 into 1 plus root 2. So 8 into 1 plus root 2. So this kind of arrangement you need to do only because the question is given in that format. Okay, now the answer format, answer options are given in this format, so that you need to make this arrangement. Otherwise, you can do this calculation. So final arrangement is depends on the question, right? See, here it is given in this format, 8 into 1 plus root 2, so that you have to do. See, the moment you see this, you understood, right? See, sum of perimeter of the square plus 2 times sum of its diagonal. So now from the area, which is equal to 4, you got the side, which is 2. So the perimeter of the square, you get 8. Diagonal 2 root 2. So sum of 2 diagonals means 4 root 2, okay, 2 times, then take 2 times of it, so that is actually 8 root 2. So effectively what you are getting is 8 plus 8 root 2, so if you take out 1, if you take out 8, 1 plus root 2. Take a minute and solve this question. Okay, so here you can see AD and BC are equal. Why? Because it is given that it is rectangle, so the opposite side has to be equal. So now, what is given? AB plus AC is equal to 5BC. Okay, why? I'm writing in that way because AD and BC are equal. So I am writing like this. It's equal to 5BC. And let me write AC minus BC is equal to 8. Same thing, I'm just writing BC instead of AD. Or I can write AC is equal to BC plus 8. Okay, I can write BC plus 8. Then what is AB? AB will be 4 into BC minus 2, right? Okay, just substitute and you can get that, okay? So AB is equal to 4 into BC minus 2. Now by using Pythagoras theorem, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square, right? AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. Now if you express AB and AC in the form of BC, we can get BC is equal to 5. Okay. Now when you get BC equal to 5, you get AB is equal to 12 and AC equal to 13. Now then area of the rectangle is 5 into 12, which is equal to 60. So you can mark C as your answer. I hope this is clear, right? See, here we are expressing this AB and AC in terms of BC.